Happy Wednesday, everybody. Good morning. I'm Sean McDonald. Thanks for joining us here on News 9 Plus on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. We've kicked off the month of September, and we got rain coming in. We'll chat with Kevin about that in a minute. But first, here are the stories that we have been following throughout the day. We are following some breaking news. The office of Governor Sununu says he is not feeling well this morning, and out of an abundance of caution, today's executive council meeting has been postponed. The office went on to say, although Governor Sununu is fully vaccinated against COVID-19, he immediately began isolating this morning and will get a COVID-19 test soon. Across the state, hospitalizations, both COVID and non-COVID related, are rising sharply. Officials say it's because many people put off medical care because of the pandemic. Now workers are leaving the industry in waves. Many of them are employees who make hospitals run efficiently and safely, like those who clean and sterilize beds and rooms.
Wages have been raised dramatically for the service sector. So folks who work environmental services in the hospitals, a very, very challenging position, can go to Arby's and make a heck of a lot more money.
Wait times at emergency departments are also exceptionally long right now. Medical officials are asking people not to go to the emergency department unless it is a true emergency. Taking a live look outside right now, the clouds over the Queen City. We are expecting heavy rain from the remnants of Hurricane Ida, and a flood watch has been posted for some areas of the state. This rain coming in later on today, right, Kevin?
Yeah, lighter version later this afternoon and for the evening commute, and heaviest after 9 or 10 o'clock tonight through just after sunrise tomorrow. And the potential is there for over 2 to 3 inches of rain, and obviously waterlogged area of the state right now. And they could actually use some of this rainfall in far northern areas, still officially under a moderate drought. So clouds continue to increase, thicken, and lower through the day. And you can see the swirl of an area of low pressure of what is left is a depression of Ida. We'll be passing to our south later tonight and early tomorrow. The far northern reaches of the heavier rainfall making their way into southern parts of the state later on tonight. Low and mid 70s with clouds thickening. Some light rain after 2 or 3 o'clock this afternoon. Turn steadier as we get our way into the evening tonight, and then heavy after 9 or 10 o'clock. I think if we're going to see flash flooding, the best potential for that will be from about midnight through about sunrise tomorrow in the area that you saw there under the watch. Beyond that, it wraps up between 6 and 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. Cooler, drier air feeds in behind that. Temperatures between 65 and 70 behind it. So again, the potential 2 to 3+ inches of rain in this zone here from the Monadnock region through the seacoast, with lesser amounts and trailing off rather quickly on the northern reaches of the remnants of Ida. Beyond that, much more comfortable with a breeze tomorrow and remaining comfortable through Saturday. A little bit of a warming trend through the holiday weekend.
Kind of a fall-like feel to the air, right? The latest St. Anselm College Survey Center poll says New Hampshire is in favor of the U.S. troop withdrawal in Afghanistan, but not how it ended. Of the more than 1,800 voters reached last week, just 9% felt the U.S. should have stayed in the region indefinitely. 58% said more time and effort should have been taken to make sure Americans and allies could get to safety. The poll also found President Biden's job approval rating is sinking in New Hampshire, with 44% approving and 55% disapproving. The poll also asked if potential refugees should be allowed to resettle in the U.S. 37% said all of them should, 54% said some, and 8% said none should be allowed in at all. Former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo is speaking one-on-one to News 9 about the situation in Afghanistan. He was in New Hampshire yesterday meeting with Republican officials and headlining a school choice forum. While leading the Department of State under former President Trump, Pompeo played a key role in negotiating an agreement with the Taliban to end the 20-year war. But he says President Biden ignored that deal.
The sequence, the withdrawal, the nature of this exit is not a victory for America. Leaders around the world are questioning whether America will be a good friend, a good partner, a good ally. Our adversaries are seeing weakness from this administration.
Pompeo is not commenting on whether he plans to run for the White House in 2024, but says Afghanistan should be on voters' minds during the midterm elections. A man faces aggravated DUI and child endangerment charges this morning after state police say he crashed multiple times into barriers and guardrails on 93 with a baby in the car. When troopers caught up with him near the 89 junction, they say the car spun out, got off the interstate, and stopped at a gas station. That's where police took Nathan Rabbit into custody. The baby's mother, Cassandra Thomas, was a passenger. She is also charged with child endangerment.
We're thankful that people call the state police and call 911 to report hazardous drivers, because that, you know, that helps us get out there. And this could have been a tragic incident today.
The mother and 8-month-old were taken to the hospital as a precaution. The baby is now with a family member. The first day of school has been pushed back for students in the Jaffrey Ringe Cooperative School District. School will now begin next Tuesday, September 7th. Comes after nearly 20 classrooms and spaces throughout the district were found to have elevated levels of mold in carpeted areas. Some areas also sustained significant water damage due to recent heavy rain. Some exciting Paralympic news for Bedford swimmer Morgan Stickney. Won the gold in the 400-meter freestyle in Tokyo. Stickney edged out fellow USA teammate Jessica Long for a time of 4 minutes and 42 seconds. This win comes after both her legs were amputated in 2018 because of a rare vascular condition. Heading into the Tokyo Games, Stickney was ranked number one in the world in the 400-meter freestyle. The St. Anselm men's soccer team has a new member this morning, a 7-year-old boy from Bedford. Liam Baskell is battling brain cancer. Through Make-A-Wish, all his soccer dreams are now coming true. Yesterday, he signed his honorary letter of intent, got a tour of the locker room, and got to spend some time on the field as well. He's part of the St. A's family now. Thanks for joining us here on News 9 Plus on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Have a great day, everybody.